And here is the Writer's Almanac for Thursday. It's the 9th of July, 2020. It's the birthday of the author Anne Radcliffe, born London, 1764, an early champion of the Gothic novel. She wrote The Italian and The Mysteries of Udolpho. Anne Radcliffe, who specialized in emotional terror as opposed to physical horror. She wrote about this. She said, "Terror and horror are so far opposite that the first expands the soul and awakens the faculties to a high degree of life. The other contracts, freezes, and nearly annihilates them." It's the birthday of the journalist Dorothy Thompson, born Lancaster, New York, 1894, foreign correspondent in Germany, had a syndicated column on the Record. She had a radio show. And in 1935, a magazine poll ranked her as the second most important woman in the United States after Eleanor Roosevelt. It's the birthday of the writer and neurologist Oliver Sacks, born London, 1933. Both his parents were doctors. He graduated from Queen's College, Oxford, and then emigrated to America for an internship in San Francisco, a city where he landed in the heyday of the 60s, where he took up weightlifting and motorcycles, and where he accepted that he was gay, and he decided he would remain celibate until he found his life partner, which took him 35 years. By 1965, Oliver Sacks was in New York. He was working at a hospital in the Bronx. He became fascinated with a group of patients who suffered from a form of encephalitis known as sleeping sickness. They were catatonic. They'd been in the hospital for decades. He began to give them doses of L-DOPA, which was just beginning to be used for patients suffering from Parkinson's. The L-DOPA roused them from their stupor into a world they did not recognize, but which often delighted them. And Oliver Sacks wrote about them in his book Awakenings, which later became a movie. The book was a hit, and Sacks kept writing about his patients, calling his books neurological novels. A few years later, he wrote The Man Who Mistook His Wife for a Hat, a man who suffered from visual agnosia and could no longer recognize his own wife. The books were bestsellers, but Sacks had his critics. One person objected to his use of real case histories. He called Sacks the man who mistook his patients for a literary career. Sacks himself said, "I would like it to be thought that I had listened carefully to what patients have told me, that I've tried to imagine what it was like for them, and that I tried to convey this." Oliver Sacks, who died of cancer in 2015. Here's a poem for today by K.A. Hayes, Petition. Here floats the mind on summer's dock, the knees loose up, hands dither off, the eyes have never heard of clocks, the mind won't feel the hours, the mind spreads wide among the hours, wide in sun. Dear sun, who gives the vision but is not the vision, who is the body and the bodies that speak into the dark, below the dark, who to the minnows in the sand-sunk tire seems like love. Make us the brightness bent through shade, the thing or rush of things that makes an opening a way. Petition by K.A. Hayes from Windthrow, used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.